PubMed is a database from the National Library of Medicine, and it covers all kinds of health science topics as well as a lot of other life sciences things. How many of you have a health sciences type topic? Quite a few. So this is maybe a database you'll want to use in addition to or instead of biological abstract. It has a few little quirks, or not quirks so much as really strong features that I want to show you that are a little bit different. So, notice it says PubMed.gov. This is a free database. After you leave the university, you can still use it. But you'll also notice the URL in the box up there. We're not at PubMed.gov. We came to it through the library's website. And as long as you're a student here, you should do that, because that way you get, basically you get the Find It button, and you get access to a lot more full text. Regular free PubMed has about 1,000 journals full text. By coming this way, we get more like 4,000. So you always want to come through the library's website, as long as you're affiliated with the university. Okay. So, earlier, which was the cancer and green tea, but in PubMed, I'm just going to put in the word cancer. And I'm not going to try to think of other terms like tumor and carcinoma and all that kind of stuff. I'm just going to put in cancer. Notice over 2 million results. This means that this is a very good database for researching cancer. Does not mean I have to panic. And what I wanted to point out was down here in the search detail, it looked for cancer, but it also looked up this term neoplasms. PubMed is a database that has real-life people looking at things, and it's updated every single day. When new articles come in, if it's about cancer, they're going to assign the word neoplasms. If it says tumor, they're going to assign the word neoplasms. If I try to think of everything, it doesn't know what to do. If I just put in one term, it will map it, what's called map it, to the medical subject headings. That's what MESH stands for, medical subject headings. And actually, there's a way to actually go to those medical subject headings, which sometimes is a good technique as well. So I'm going to show you that. So instead of PubMed, I'm going to go to the medical subject headings. And I'm going to search for cancer there. And look at that, neoplasms. So it knows that cancer and neoplasms are the same thing. And it gives me a definition. But the really nice thing is it has this tremendous structure of subdivisions, I guess. Say of the subject. So if I don't want to search just everything in cancer, I'm interested in the blood supply to tumors. I could say blood supply. If I'm interested in the causes, I could choose etiology, which means causes. By checking those, I can limit my search, or I can just say restrict to major topics. That means I want the records where cancer is one of the main ideas in the article, not just something mentioned tangentially. So having checked that, I'm going to say send to search box. And so now I have neoplasms as the major topic, and I'm going to search PubMed. And now I have a mere 1.88 million records instead of 2 million. All right, that's okay. I'm going to, rather than write about it, I'm just going to search for my other idea now. And my other idea is green tea. I don't think green tea is likely to be a medical concept, so I am going to try to think of other terms. And in this bottle of green tea, it says right here that it contains EGCG. That's the ingredient that's supposed to be good for you, so I'm going to look for that too. searches I've been doing are listed, just like a search history. It is my search history. And I can combine them myself by typing in the search box. So I'm going to look for number one, that's cancer. Whoops, I'm going to actually say number four, cancer as the main idea. And PubMed likes to put these things in all caps, so I'll do that. Number five. So now I have about 1,000 records. So if I'm using PubMed, this is a much better way to do it, is to do one idea at a time in the search box and then go to the history and combine them. Now there are also some limits here. And PubMed has the limits that other databases have, the publication date and language. But they also have a lot of other kind of limits that are specific to medicine. So if I want primary research, I could look for clinical trials. I know that's going to be primary research. I can look for things about humans. There are some subsets. So if you're researching something in veterinary medicine or dentistry, you could choose that subset. I'm going to leave it at this. And search. And so out of that 2 million, I have 10. About humans, cancer's the main idea, something about green tea, published in the last 3 years in English, a clinical trial. So this would probably work for my 10 to 40 if this is the one I'm using. In order to see the abstract, I change it here under display settings to show the abstract.